Thank you for joining the worship services of Choteau, Brady, and Dutton United Methodist Churches. I'm Pastor Julie King, and I'm so grateful for digital technology that allows you to join us from wherever you are in the world. You can join us every week by clicking the links on our Facebook at facebook.com/ChoteauUMC or on our website at umchoteau.net. If you like what we are doing and would like to financially support us in ministry, you can find more contact information on our website, and again, that's umchoteau.net. We're so grateful that you are joining us.
Grace and peace to each of you. Thank you so much for joining us through digital worship this week. I would just like to remind everyone that we are very diligently working on our plans to be able to safely worship indoors. Thank you so much to the leadership teams of each church that are able to help me make sure that we are able to come together in person to worship as the weather gets colder throughout the next several months. And I just am really, really, really looking forward to being back inside of the buildings and to be with all of you as you can. I would again remind you that we do need to wear our masks. We will still be social distanced and spread out. A few things will look different in person, but for the most part, it will feel like a somewhat normal worship experience, and I am very grateful for that. I would also remind you that if you are feeling ill with any type of symptoms, to please stay home. There's no reason to take a chance at spreading it throughout our churches. And if you are somebody who might be more at risk due to your health or any underlying conditions, your age, anything like that, just please be smart about it. And let's all do our part, every one of us, not just within the sanctuaries, but out in the communities, do our parts to make sure that we are doing the best that we can to keep everyone safe. Throughout the month, every month for at least the foreseeable future, while we remain in this time of weird worship in the pandemic, we will be worshiping in our churches on a rotation. Brady will be on the first Sunday every month. We will have communion with that service. On the second Sunday of the month, we will also have communion, and that service will be in Dutton. On the third Sunday of the month, we will be here in Shodo, and that service will also have communion. And then the fourth Sunday, and if there's a fifth Sunday, at this time, we're planning to do digital worship for those Sundays. That might change. We might end up adding another in-person service depending on which direction the cases go. But at this time, I would officially like to say welcome. Thank you for joining us for worship. Please make sure that you're reading through your newsletter and watching for any email updates that come out. Check out our Facebook pages for current events that are going on within each of our churches, and you can stay up to date with all of the happenings that way. Now it is time to join together for our opening hymn.
Every day or all the way, He will will take care of you. Nothing you ask will be denied. God will take care of you.
During my sermon, I'm going to be talking a lot about prayer. And next week, we will actually be diving into the very weird worship way of praying in unison. I will be particularly looking at the Lord's Prayer and going very in depth with the Lord's Prayer. So for these next 2 weeks, prayer is going to be a pretty important part of our services. Prayer is important to us throughout any service, and this week I just would really like us to really just think about what prayer means to us individually and as a whole community. And as we begin to start thinking about that thought, I would invite you to join me for the prayer hymn, and it's Spirit of a Living God. As you invite the Spirit into your space, prepare your mind and your heart. Let your attitude be an attitude of prayer.
Of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Melt me, mold me, fill the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Melt me, mold me, fill me, use me, Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me.
At this time, would you take a few moments for your own silent prayer, meditation, and confession? Gracious and loving God, today I just want to give you thanks. Thanks for never leaving us and promising to always be with us, no matter what it is that we are going through in our life. Lord, today I lift up anyone who is suffering. suffering physically because of an injury, because of illness, because of a disease. Lord, I pray also for those who are suffering mentally, ones who are feeling depressed, ones who are worried, ones who, despite every effort to try to get it right in life, it just seems like they can't quite make it. Lord, I pray for those who are suffering spiritually, the ones who find it hard to feel you in their life, the ones who find it hard to turn to you. Lord, I pray for them, and I just pray that not only will you be with them, but that you would guide somebody there to help them, to be with them, and to show them your love. Lord, today I also pray and I thank you for the ways that you are so, so active in our lives, the ways that you are able to heal us, to make us whole, the ways that you bring us together as a whole parish, as a family in each of our churches. Lord, today I also just very specifically want to thank you for the churches and the people in Shoto, Brady, and Dutton. Lord, I pray for our ministry going forward together. And may we all know how active you are in these churches and how much you love us. And now, Lord, we all come together in unison as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Today's scripture reading comes from the book James, chapter 5, verses 13 through 16. Are any among you suffering? They should pray. Are any cheerful? They should sing songs of praise. Are any among you sick? They should call for the elders of the church and have them pray over them, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise them up. And anyone who has committed sins will be forgiven.
Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The prayer of righteous is powerful and effective. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
This week I continue on with our weird worship series. And this week I'm going to be talking about healing. Over the last couple weeks, of course, we talked about communion, we talked about baptism, we talked about the ways that some of our practices and our most sacred traditions of the church can seem a little bit weird, especially if you're not familiar with the practices that we do. Healing is one of those that can seem a little bit weird. Have any of you ever been a part of a healing service in the church? If you have not, I admit it can feel slightly awkward the very first time that you participate, especially because it's new and it's different. It's weird. Essentially, a healing service is a time that you can come forward There is a time of prayer, very intentional prayer, prayer for healing. And then a lot of times there are outward signs such as laying of the hands, holding hands together, and anointing with oil on the forehead, just typically a little cross on the forehead with oil. And these are just reminders of God's love and the way that he works in our life. The services are absolutely beautiful. And once it is safe for us to be able to do one in person, I would love to offer healing services within our congregations. Like I said, though, they might seem a little bit weird. Why do you suppose that healing is so important to us in the church and in the Christian tradition? Why do we heal? Why do we pray for healing? Why do we ask for healing? Why do we offer a whole service on healing? Well, as you all, I hope, know, you know that the New Testament is full of stories that Jesus healed. He healed the ones that were of the least, the outcasts, the ones that didn't matter to anyone else. Jesus healed them and he made them whole. There's also stories in the New Testament that you can read where Jesus sent the disciples out on ministries of healing, and the disciples themselves went out to pray and to perform healing acts, to show God's love through prayers of healing. So healing is important to us. Healing is very important to us. I'm sure that all of you at some point in your life have said, hey, I'm going through this. I would really appreciate prayers. And people will reply by praying. They pray for a quick recovery. They pray for a cure. They pray for comfort. Whatever it is that you need, people pray for healing. Healing is very important. But how did it become a tradition in the church? We know that Jesus healed, but how did the church itself end up incorporating it as part of their own traditions and part of their own practices? The United Methodist Book of Worship, to me, summarizes it in the introduction the best. There's no way that I could word it better. And it's fascinating to me, some of the information that they include. So I would like to share a bit of what that introduction says about healing. The first thing that it shares is that, very interestingly, the root word for hit, or the root of the word healing in the New Testament Greek is sozo. And that is the exact same root word for the words of salvation and wholeness. Salvation and wholeness seem like a pretty good way to define or to describe what it is to be healed. To be whole, to be made whole, is definitely a way that we would describe what it is to be healed. The Book of Worship also says that spiritual healing is God's work of offering persons balance, harmony, and wholeness of the mind, the body, spirit, and relationships. And it says that this happens through confession, through reconciliation, and through forgiveness. It also says that through such healing, God's works to bring about reconciliation create a stronger connection between God and humanity, among individuals and communities, within each person, their own being, and in between humanity and the rest of God's creation, all of the things of the world, the beautiful trees, the earth, all of the rest of creation, the animals. When we are made whole, we have that wonderful connection. So what does that really mean? Well, to me, what the Book of Worship is pointing out here through this introduction is that healing is something that's very powerful. Healing is not just something that we hope for or something that we pray for. It's something that can really happen, and it happens because of God. Healing is not something that's magical. It's not some weird voodoo type practice. Prayers for healing come from God, and they are of God. And God can truly make us whole in all ways, through our mind, through our body, our spirit. And yes, even relationships can be reconciled and be made better through healing that happens through God. Now, healing services and healing prayers, when we offer these type of prayers and when we do healing services, in no way, shape, or form are we trying to offer a cure. Nor does a healing service ever take precedence over any type of psychotherapy or medicine. The Methodist Church firmly believes that people should seek counseling and that they should seek medical care. Those are good things. And the healing services are definitely not meant to offer a cure or to be an alternative to therapy or to medicine, but instead they are to offer a companion to it, a way that makes it spiritual. I once, at the end of a movie, remember hearing a quote saying that science and medicine can only go so far, and then comes God. And then comes God. And I think that that's really a good way to summarize why healing is so important. Yes, we need physicians, we need therapists, but we also need God. And when we include God into our healing, when we pray for healing through God, it makes it go to a whole new level with our spiritual well-being. Something else that I really want to point out and make sure that we all understand is that God does not ever promise us that we will not go through suffering. We know that we're going to go through suffering, but what God does promise us is that He will never, ever forsake us, that He will always be with us through that suffering. And it's because of that promise. When we put all of our faith into that promise that God will be with us even while we're suffering, it is then that we are able to feel God's presence. When we are injured, when we are sick, we're able to feel God's presence. Anytime that we are emotionally hurt, we're able to feel God's presence with us. The other thing is that I want to point out that God does not ever promise us that we will be cured of all illnesses. We know that we are human beings, and eventually all of us will inevitably face death. We will all die. None of us are going to be cured of all illnesses on the face of this earth. But something that is amazing is, despite maybe you are facing a cancer diagnosis and you've done everything you can, there's no cure for it, and you know that inevitably death will be coming, the thing that can still happen through healing is that we are able to be made whole. We are able to grow closer with God. Our hearts are able to be stronger with our own spiritual belief and our own faith. There's that balance that I talked about between the body, mind, spirit, and all of our relationships that happens. And when everything is in balance and in sync, we are made whole. Remember that wholeness that can be used to describe healing. That's what can occur. Isn't it amazing, too, the ways that all of our body is connected to each other? Have any of you ever felt down, when you feel sad, if you feel depressed, when your heart is hurting, have you ever noticed that your body physically reacts to it and begins to hurt as well? You can feel it through, at least for me, through my neck and through my shoulders. You can get headaches from it. Your joints can ache. You can feel sick to your stomach. Everything is all connected in one beautiful way. And so it is important for us to pray and to allow God to work in us so that all parts of our bodies can be made whole. And when those do happen, when we feel that peace and we feel that wholeness, there are times that physical healing can actually also begin to take place. Somebody who might be struggling emotionally or mentally or spiritually, sometimes they kind of, their body naturally puts a block up and they are unable to begin healing. But once that wholeness is achieved, the physical healing can begin as well. It is a beautiful, beautiful part of the way God created us. You know, so I think the big question then is, what does all of this really mean? We know that healing is important, but what are we supposed to do about it? How are we supposed to continuously seek this healing, especially right now at a time? Like I said, we can't have an actual healing service because of the COVID regulations and guidelines. So what are we supposed to do? What are we supposed to do to practice this service of healing, to achieve this healing that we strive for? What are we supposed to do? Well, our scripture reading answers that best. The scripture reading again came from James. It's chapter 5, verses 13 through 16, and it begins with a question. It says, "Are any of you suffering? They should pray. Are any of you cheerful? They should sing songs of praise. Are any among you sick? They should call for the elders of the church and have them pray over them, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord." The prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise them up, and anyone who has committed sins will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The prayer of the righteous is powerful and effective. The prayer of the righteous is powerful and effective. That, my friends, is exactly what we are to do. We are to pray. We're to pray for ourselves. We're to pray for each other. And when we do, we will be made whole. I would like to share a quick story with each of you. This is a story that has really developed over probably the last 7 or 8 years. And it's a story about the power of prayer. And I'm sure that each of us have our own personal story that we could share, but this story is about a little boy. A little boy who was out playing on the playground at his daycare. This was down in Georgia. While he was outside playing, a tree branch broke and it came crashing down from just a big gust of wind. And where this tree branch landed, unfortunately, was on top of this little boy's head. I found out about this because a friend of mine had shared a prayer request for this little boy, and it began going viral on Facebook, and I ended up following this little boy's page that his mom had made. She made an update page, and she would post on it several times a day. It became very therapeutic to her, almost her journal. And I began following this little boy's journey toward recovery. I forget how many different brain surgeries he went through, but it was multiple brain surgeries. He also had other injuries that he had to recover from, and he went from being a very normal, happy, playful little boy to one who could no longer talk. He could no longer walk. He really could hardly do anything. For years, his parents, his grandparents, would desperately plea for prayers. Prayers of comfort, prayers of strength, of course, prayers of healing for their little boy. And you know what happened? These prayers ended up spreading. The little boy's page on Facebook has still to this day over 1 million followers. Over 1 million people connected together, praying for healing, praying for peace. And the reason I share this story with you is because for me, something in my life changed when I really began following this page and being connected with so many other people who were praying. What I found was I looked forward to the updates, and it became something that I would get on my phone and I would quickly look and type in and search for the page so that I could see how the little boy was doing each day as he slowly began to recover. And I found myself praying more often. I prayed every single day, not only for that little boy, but for other people. I would seek out other people who needed prayers. If someone came on my mind, I would pray for them. I prayed for myself more, and I prayed for my family more. And prayer really became a part of my daily life. And as it did, I became a better person. I was made whole. My own spiritual well-being grew. My mental and emotional state was better. I physically felt better. I was happier. And it was amazing. This little boy, unfortunately, did end up passing away. He ended up getting sick, and his brain injury and the multiple other problems that he had in his little body, it just couldn't handle it anymore. And he did end up passing away almost 2 years ago now. But his mom continues to update, and she continues to share her life journey now with the millions of people that follow her. And she's very inspirational, very uplifting, and she's connected many, many other children who need prayers with her page. It's beautiful, and it's amazing, and it's just truly amazing the amount of connection that can happen through healing prayers. And so I would like to encourage each of you this week to really take healing seriously, to take the need for prayer seriously, to do what the scripture says and pray. If you need to set a reminder or several alarms throughout the day in your phone, I would invite you to do so. Just a little vibration that goes off every couple of hours or however often you want to set it that reminds you to pray. I would also encourage you to specifically keep a list, an ongoing list of people or events or situations or feelings in your own well-being that you need to pray for, that you want to pray for. And pray for them daily. Pray over them. Specifically lift them up in prayer. Another prayer practice that I love is to be able to begin my day with prayer and not say amen in the morning when I start that. And throughout the day, as something comes about or comes up, I say a little prayer for it, and I don't say amen until the very end of the day. It's just this big ongoing prayer. Friends, I invite you and I encourage you to pray so that you may find healing, not only for yourselves, but to share the love of God with others through healing prayers. And now at this time, I would invite each of you to join me in prayer as we close our service out. Let us pray. Almighty God, I pray that our brothers and sisters may be comforted in their suffering and made whole. When they are afraid, give them courage, Lord. When they feel weak, grant them your strength. When they are afflicted, afford them patience. When they are lost, offer them hope. When they are alone, move us to their side, Lord. And I pray this in your name. Amen. And now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship, and the power of the Holy Spirit be with you all now and forevermore. Amen. Go forth in peace.
In the midst of new dimensions, in the face of changing ways, who will lead the pilgrim peoples wandering in their separate ways? God of rainbow, fiery pillar, leading where the eagles soar, we are people, ours the journey, now and ever. Now and evermore. Through the flood of starving people, warring factions and despair, who will lift the olive branches? Who will light the flame of care? God of rainbow, fiery pillar, leading where the eagles soar, stand a world divided by our own self-seeking schemes. Grant that we, your global village, might envision wider dreams. God of rainbow, fiery pillar, leading where the eagles soar, we are people, ours the journey, now and ever. We are man and we are woman, all persuasions old and young, each a gift in your creation, each a love song to be sung. God of rainbow, fiery pillar, leading where the eagles soar, we are people, ours a journey, now and ever. Threats of dire predictions cause us to withdraw in pain. May your blazing phoenix spirit resurrect the church again. God of rainbow, fiery pillar, leading where the eagles soar, we are people.